Hello, welcome to software testing methodology. Today I am going to discuss about domain and interface testing. So before this, I already told you that domain testing, what how the domain testing defines, how the path can be defined in the particular domain, if there is number of domains, what are the how the testing applies on the particular domain to domain, if there is a domain testing applied. So what are the bugs raises in that particular domain? I already discussed about all this. So now here, I am going to discuss about the how interface testing performs in particular domain. So whatever the domain you have taken, so the interface, how the interface will be generates between one domain to the another domain. If there is any generation of domain, so how the interface can be cooperate to one domain to the another domain, all can be discussed in domains and interface testing, and how the compatibility can be performed between two or more domains, all can be discussed in this interface testing. So domain testing plays a very important role in integration testing. So before that, what is meant by integration testing? So integration testing means combining two or more units or two or more components and testing applies. It is known as the integration testing. So this integration testing I already discussed in the levels of testing. Your first level, second level, third level and fourth level, like unit testing, integration testing, component testing and system testing. So combining two or more components and performs the testing is known as the integration testing, and this domain testing mainly plays a very important role in integration testing. So it is a technique used to determine whether the components are accurate or not. So whether the components, whatever the components we are using in the software application can be tested. So those components can be performed the speed, based on the speed. Is that component is accurate or not? Mainly this technique is used to determine that whether the components are accurate or not. So there are some of the possible of interfaces are as follows. So these are the some of the possible interfaces. So first one is global variables of two components, data objects of two components and subroutine calls of the two components. So you all well known about the variables declaration. That variable declaration can be defined as a global variable or local variables. So if you take any two components performing the integration testing, so that is the main technique to determine whether the components are accurate or not. So generally this is the interface way which defines any other variables can be accessing as globally or locally. So this is one of the possible form of interface which defines like global variables of two components. So there are the variables defined is nothing but a local variable and global variable. Global variables can be used to perform two components. Accessing all the global variables can be performed by two of components. So in that case, we'll go for this is the one of the possible form of interface and perform the interface testing. The another possible is nothing but objects, nothing but data object. Whatever the object defines in that particular data objects of two components can be used, is one of the main possible form of interface testing. So next one, calling function and called function, nothing but subroutine calls of two components. So if there is any calling function from one domain to the another domain, if there is any called function from one domain to the another domain, there also the interface testing will be applied. So this is also one of the possible form of interface and performs the interface testing. So global variables are also defines as one of the interface testing way, and data objects of two components which can be defined is another interface testing performs, and subroutine calls and nothing but called function and caller function and called function also one of the interface testing. So these are all the possible form of interfaces. Next one. So interface testing can be defined as a method of testing in which all the subroutine is made to detect presence of any error. So generally subroutine calls nothing but call function or caller call function or called function. So this is mainly is used to detect the errors, nothing but bugs. If there is any bugs raises in the interfaces, whichever the interface we are using and interacting between two or more domains, in that case whatever the bugs can be raised, in that case this testing is mainly used for to detect the presence of any errors or bugs. So that is the way to define the interface testing, and some of the applications of domain testing for interface testing are as follows. So what are the applications? Now you will see the what the applications used in the domain test, domain and interface testing. The first one is nothing but domains and range. Second one is nothing but closure compatibility. So third one is nothing but span compatibility. Next, fourth one is nothing but interface range and domain compatibility. So domains and range, the name itself tells what are the domains present and what is the range between those domains can be defined in this application. Next one is closure compatibility. I already discussed about the closure bug, nothing but if there is any wrong path available, in that case it is called as a closure bug. So how the compatibility can be defined in the closure way, domain closure, all can be, this is one of the application of interface testing. Next, span compatibility. So is there any ranges of between domains and ranges of between two or more components can be defined span compatibility, nothing but span time. So interface range and domain compatibility. So what the interface we are using in the domain and what is that interface range and how the compatibility can be defined in between those domains can be discussed in interface and interface range and domain compatibility. So these are all the some of the applications of domain testing for interface testing. So first, let us discuss about first application is domains and range. So first, what is meant by domains? Domains are nothing but the values taken as input by the function. So whatever the inputs we are taking, it is nothing but a domain. So every software application is need to be defined, tested, or whatever implemented, there is a input values and output values, input components and output components, whatever. So in this domain testing, whatever the input values we are giving, that input values is nothing but we can call it as a domain, and output values is next nothing but range. So that is what I am saying here. Range is just opposite of domains. So ranges are the values obtained as output from the function. What are the function we are, here I am taking the function. So for that function, what are the input values we are giving is nothing but a domain, and what are the output we are accessing is nothing but a range. So nothing but boundary, range is nothing but limit. So what the range we are given, so up to that output values, the range values can be defined as the output values. In more testing techniques, more focuses is on input values, but interface testing is mainly focuses on output values. So normal in any testing techniques like path testing or state testing or flow graph testing or transaction flow testing, data flow testing, mainly it focuses on input values. In interface and domain testing, only mainly it focuses on output values, because the range, whatever the range we are given, is mainly depends on the output values. So this is what the point here. The most techniques focuses on input values, but in the interface testing mainly focuses on output values. So interface testing is also used to check the accuracy between the domains and range. So I discussed it in the previous slide. So accuracy, nothing but speed. So whatever the domains and whatever the range we are given, from 1 to 18 or 1 to 20. So between those, all the input values can be defined, between all the output values can be defined from the output side. All can be checked the accuracy between the domains and range. So this is about domains and range. So next one is nothing but closure compatibility. The next application is nothing but closure compatibility. And this closure compatibility is used to determine the closure affinity between the domains and range. So those, let us take the domains lie between numbers like 1 to 18. So remember that 1 to 18 is nothing but a range which is, lies between the domain. The closure compatibility can be determined by taking two types of number lines. They are as follows. First one is thick number line and thin number line. So two number lines. This the main closure compatibility, how we can say the closure compatibility defined, and it is one of the main application in the interface testing. Bit like here I am taking the some of the number of domains, like 1 to 18 is the domain range. So 1 is starting and 18 is the ending. So after 19, if you take the input value as the 19, no, it is not a domain range. So it leads to the bug. So that is nothing but here I am taking 1 to 18, and there are some of the number lines which defines closure compatibility. So that number line is nothing but thick number line means closed line, thin number line means open line. So open boundary, closed boundary, how we discuss, same as thin number line means open. So open means taking the input value. Closer means is nothing but up to there, the values is not taken or the variables is not taken or the any components is not entered. All this can be defined as the number line, thick and thin. Thick means closed and thin means open. So here, these two lines can be represented in four possible ways. First one, number of possibility ways can be defined like thick and thin. Thick lines on top and bottom, it is one of the possibility. And thin line on top and thick line on bottom, it is another possibility. And vice versa for that above one, thick line on top and thin line at bottom, another possibility way. And thin lines on top and bottom. So this is the four possible ways which defines in the number line closure compatibility. So the diagram represents here, see this diagram, the first one is thick lines on top and bottom. This is the top, this is the bottom. So all these lines are thick. So it is nothing but one possibility way. And thin line at the bottom, sorry, thin line at the top and thick line at the bottom. This is another possible way. Next, thick line at top and thin line at bottom. This is another possible way. Next, all thin lines on top and bottom. So this is another possibility way. Range and domain closure compatibility. So this defines the domain compatibility, and by using this closure compatibility, there is need to perform the domain testing. So this is about closure compatibility. So next one is application. Next application is span compatibility. How the span compatibility defined? So see here, the span compatibility is mainly defines in 12 possible ways. Closure compatibility defines in 4 possible ways. Span compatibility defines in total 12 possible ways. So these are all span compatibles, like 0 to 18. I am taking here the domain range is 0 to 18. And how the span compatibility defines means thick and thin lines on top, thick lines at the bottom are shown in figure 1. So thick and thin here, this domain consists of both number lines, nothing but thick and thin. So thick line, thick and thin line on top. So both thick line, this is the thick line and this is the thin line, and this is the and both and the thick lines at the bottom. So this is nothing but one compatibility, one possible way. And second possible way is nothing but thick lines on top, thick and thin lines on bottom are shown in figure 2. So thick lines on top, thick and thin lines on bottom. So nothing but this is one of the compatibility. Likewise, all these are all 12 compatibilities which defines in the domain testing as a span compatibility. So span defines how many number of possible ways between the thick line and thin. Here I am taking the thick line and thin line on the particular domain. So thick and thin line at bottom, thick and thin line at top. So this is one of the possible ways. Next, thick line at the top, thin line at the top, thick and thin line at the bottom. So this is another possible way. Next, on the top both thick lines and on the top bottom both thin lines. This is another possible way. Likewise, there are 12 compatibility ways which defines in the domain testing, and that compatibility is known as a span compatibility. So this leads to reduce of bugs, more bugs which defines in the domain and interface testing. So this is a span compatibility and is one of the application. Next, coming to the last one, interface range and domain compatibility. So this, the name itself defines what is the range of the interface and what is the compatibility. So this application of domain testing is also very important for interface testing, because it tests the range and domain compatibility among the caller and called function. So I already told that the main interface testing is mainly based on calling and called function, nothing but subroutine calls. So when the testing applies on this interface testing, it tests the range and domains. Domains will be checked, what the domain we have taken, and which the called function, from where the called function, the caller function which is defined from one domain to the another domain. That interface will be checked as domains and range. What is the range between that domain to the, that one domain to the another domain. All can be defined is nothing but a interface and domain compatibility. And this mainly performs in the interface testing. So next one, it is the responsibility of the caller to provide the valid inputs to the caller routine. So all the inputs should not taken by the domain compatibility, and the compatibility should be defined in the interfaces where the input values is taken. That input values may be valid, must be valid. So So that valid inputs gives the best results in the domain and interface testing and reduces the bugs which occurs in this interface testing. So next one, after getting the valid inputs, the test will be done on every input variable independent of every other input variable. So here two inputs are taken from one domain to the another domain. So whatever the input test can be defined on one input variable can be independent, not dependency should not provide. So every input variable can be defined independently and test also applied on the independently. So this defines the mostly in the interface testing and which performs the domain compatibility. So this is nothing but interface range and domain compatibility. So and these are all the four main applications which defines in interface testing, nothing but domain and interface testing. So these are all the some of the applications which performs in the domain and interface testing. So span compatible domain and range, span compatibility, closure compatibility, interface range and domain compatibility. All these applications can be performed to perform the domain and interface testing. So hope you all understand about this domain and interface testing. So thank you. Thank you very much.